Na entrevista deste sábado, o Jornal da Cultura conversa com o primatólogo holandês Frans de Waal, que lançou recentemente no país um livro sobre a inteligência emocional dos animais. Na obra, ele mostra que nós estamos muito mais conectados a primatas, cães e elefantes do que poderíamos imaginar.
Dr. de Waal, in your books, you describe many rituals and ways that the chimpanzees and apes mediate conflicts, like grooming each other after some fight. What are the similar ways the humans do that?
Yeah, so chimpanzees, for example, after a fight, they may kiss and embrace each other. So usually within 10 minutes, they come together and they have some contact. Then after that, they may groom. I think humans, we usually do it less physically. We apologize or we say something or we do something nice, like bringing someone some coffee as a sort of reconciliation. But of course, within families, it can also be physical. It can even be sexual. So that happens, for example, in some species of primates. And certainly kissing and embracing are very human-like behaviors. And so humans do that too.
So would you say that the verbal language made us forget our capability of understanding the body language?
Yeah, I think that's an interesting question, because we humans, we rely so much on language. We pay so much attention to what someone says that we sometimes forget how sensitive we are to facial expressions, to the tone of voice, to the body. So we are actually very good at reading body language, but we sometimes forget that. And so, for example, if I watch debates on TV between politicians, I often turn off the sound. I don't want to hear what they're saying because they're lying anyway. I don't want to see what they're saying. I just want to see their body language. And I think it's actually much more informative than their language.
Would you say Donald Trump was a alpha male? Behavior like an alpha male?
The problem with that is that I use the word alpha male for chimpanzee males, for example, and most alpha males that I know, they are good leaders. They keep the group together, they bring parties together, they make sure that there's order in the society, and they are empathic towards others. And those are qualities that some leaders in the world don't have. So we call them sometimes alpha males because they are dominant and they dominate the political landscape, but they don't act like alpha males in the terms of leadership. And so leadership, and females also can do that, females can be leaders too. Leadership is that you bring parties together and keep order in the society, and not all alpha males are good at that.